Okay, so I'm here to review a horror film called The Possession from 2012. It's an American supernatural horror film which was produced by Sam Raimi and Robert Tapper of Evil Dead fame. And it stars the one, the only Jeffrey Dean Morgan, or as a lot of people know him, Negan from The Walking Dead. If you enjoy The Walking Dead and you enjoy Negan, then that's all you need to know. You will enjoy this film. Jeffrey Dean Morgan is great in it, as he is in pretty much everything he's in. The story is based on the alleged haunted Dybbuk box, and apparently the director cited films like The Exorcist as inspiration. It's quite an oldish film, as in it's released in 2012, so you know, we're getting on 10 years old here. And it did receive mixed reviews from critics, but I actually think they were a bit harsh on it. It starts off with the middle-aged woman who's looking at an old wooden box with Hebrew writing on it. And we soon get introduced to the main family, who are a separated man and his wife. You've got the basketball coach, husband, who played by Jeffrey Dean Morgan, and his wife, Stephanie, played by Kyra Sedgwick. Both of these people do great in the roles, but it's one of those films, there's two young girls in it. And in a lot of horror movies and other movies in general, I'll tell you that child actors are absolutely pants. However, these two girls are pretty darn good. In fact, the one who things will mainly focus around, I think, is excellent. Some of the stuff that happens to her character, just the way she acts it, wow. If you like The Poltergeist, you like Exorcist, and you like things like The Conjuring and stuff, then this film is probably really right down your alley. And it's actually one I've not heard a lot of people talk about. So I think it's a little bit of a missed gem here. Apparently it's based on a true story, which, you know, I'm someone that when I see this sort of conjuring thing flying through the air, people's eyes spinning, I say take that with a pinch of salt. But I suppose when some people see that based on a true story, it adds to the spookiness. The fact that this could possibly in some way, even if in a reduced way, have happened in real life. Anyway, it's a great film to watch for a little bit of a Halloween pick-me-up at this moment in time. So it's Kerr9000 signing off, saying have a great day, look after yourselves, and happy Halloween.